How is all doing? This is part 5 of my Sega Saturn collection, and this will be the final part. Like other side is the Sega Saturn is an awesome console, and I'd highly recommend it, even though it's a failure and it didn't do well at all. There's so many great games that came out for it, so I'd highly recommend it. With the games that I can't find, we'll talk about Power Drift. Power Drift is an awesome off road. Racing game, on a variety of different tracks, and it's mostly 2D sprites, but it's awesome. It's brilliant. The sensation of speed, and in the arcade, the actual car moves as you turn. So, and great music and stuff. It's just an awesome racing game, and you know it's one of Sega's best games. And when I heard it was coming out for the Sega Saturn, I couldn't wait to get it. But it wasn't released in Europe. It was only released in Japan. Why, I don't know. But that worked out better for me because Japanese games cost a lot less than getting a European version of a game. You know. So yeah, and it's awesome on the Sega Saturn. The only thing that's missing is the arcade cabinet that actually moves when you turn the steering wheel. Now there is a steering wheel for the Sega Saturn. It's good, but it's not great. The arcade racer for the Sega Saturn is good. I mean, would definitely recommend it, but it's not the same as the arcade. But apart from that, the game is spot on perfect. 60 frames per second. The sprites are huge. The cars are huge with big chunky tours, and the music's awesome. So Power Drift, deadly. You know what I mean? I have it in the room somewhere. Now in Japan, they released the games on normal size CD cases. You know, they weren't like the big huge ones that we use. Cause in Japan, the Sega Saturn lasted a lot longer because it was a lot more popular over there. I think the Sega Saturn went till as early as 2000 in Japan. I think sold a lot more and has a bigger game library over there. It was only when the Sega Saturn reached North America and Europe, that's when they fucked up, you know. Yeah, so Power Drift, as another one, it's awesome. I would highly recommend it. Deep Fury it's sort of like Resident Evil, except it's underwater. It's underwater, and it's a very good game. It's not as good as Resident Evil, but it's pretty good, and it runs pretty well on the Sega Saturn. Now, again, We got the Japanese version because it's cheaper, you know what I mean, and it's a cool game. I'd highly recommend it. So for Power Drift, the score would give a Power Drift. It's arcade perfect. The only thing that's missing is the arcade cabinet. So I'd have to give a 10 out of 10. Seriously, we actually like Power Drift more than Sega Rally, because it's just the sensation of speed and the tracks. It's cool, like, you know, in my opinion. And there's more tracks in Power Drift, and there's different drivers to choose from. So 10 out of 10 for Power Drift, in my opinion. Now, Deep Fear is a great game. We'll give it 8 out of 10. It's a lot more slower paced than Resident Evil, and the controls are a bit more awkward. But it's meant to be set in the future, deep underwater. And the zombies under the water. So, yeah, Deep Fear is a good one. Now, another one, Creature Shock, is another Japanese game. We couldn't get it in on the European version. Creature Shock, it's like a full motion video first person shooter game. You're like a microscopic little man, right? And you're going inside the body of this big huge alien creature, and you're shooting all the things that are inside of it. All these critters, you know, bacteria or viruses. It's a pretty unique game, but the thing is, it's not like Doom, or it's not like Quake. It's not like that at all. It's like pretty linear, if you know what I mean. You have to go this way or the other way, and the game you start off on like three passageways. They sort of look like big arteries or veins. It's sort of like the movie Inner Space, if you've ever seen that, which is an awesome movie with Dennis Quaid. Inner Space, you're microscopic and you're set inside the body of this fella. Well, similar thing, except this is a creature of an alien or something. And I don't know why you're microscopic and why you're trying to save this creature, but it's very unique, but it's very boring and it's very repetitive. And I mean, you press, so you choose which one you want to go through, then the game moves you forward and it stops you when enemies appear on screen, and a target reticule will appear on screen and you just shoot all the stuff on the screen. And then when you have them all killed, the game moves you, the game tells you don't want to go this way, that way, or the other way. So it's strange, but it runs pretty well, but it uses full motion video for the cutscenes and for the characters. So it's unique, and as far as full motion video games go, this is probably one of the best, because it gives you more control and more things to do. But it's still very scripted and very linear, so it's not like Doom, it's not like Quake, you know what I mean? So it's strange, and it does get boring and repetitive, and I never finished it, and I never even got halfway through the game, because I kept getting killed over and over again. I just didn't want to bother playing it anymore. So Creature Shock, it's a strange, unique game. It's not terrible, but it's not great either. So for Creature Shock, I'd give it a 5 out of 10, and I wouldn't recommend that game, to be honest with you. Well, another game, I can't even pronounce it. Now this is the Japanese version of Doom. Just to give you an example of what a Japanese game looks like, you know, the Japanese did everything right with Doom. Well, with the Sega Saturn. Well, the Japanese version of Doom isn't much better than the European version. It's slightly better, but still, it's still a bad version of the game, you know, the Japanese version, you know. And they use the same cover as the PlayStation, which looks awesome. It's far better than the European version with The Last Soul, in my opinion. And it runs at a steady frame rate of 24 frames per second. And we believe the two-player mode is back in this one, and it has the lighting effects. Like when you get the berserk thing, the screen turns all red. So it's closer to the PlayStation version, but it's still a bad version of the game. It's better than the European version. So if you are going to get Doom for the Sega Saturn, I recommend getting the Japanese version, because it's cheaper and it's the best version of the game, in my opinion. Like, you know. And at the back of the box, it's all in Japanese, but you can, the best stuff, you know, you can read, you know. Yeah, so the Japanese version of Doom, we'll give it a 7 out of 10. It's just the frame rate is still bad, and there's certain levels that are just completely unplayable. Like, there's a level called Perfect Hatred, which is so unplayable. It just, the frame rate comes to like a 4 frames per second. Really, really bleeding jerky, you know. And that's what the disc looks like. And I didn't know that Resident Evil was in there, you know, but like, it is. Resident Evil by the Sega Saturn. I'll get that down in a minute, right? But Doom on the Sega Saturn, 7 out of 10. I wouldn't recommend it, even though it's a better version than the European version. We'll stick with, get on the PlayStation or something else, you know. Now, Resident Evil on the Sega Saturn. It's okay, in my opinion, this has an extra monster that isn't in the PlayStation version. It's a hunter or something like that. But it's pretty good on the Sega Saturn, but the PlayStation version is superior, in my opinion. But this has an extra monster, and it think this has a battle mode that wasn't in the Sony PlayStation version. So it is pretty good, I have to say. Yeah, just the characters look a bit more blocky, and it's just not as good. Yeah, but Resident Evil and Sega Saturn are given 8 out of 10. Very good game, like, you know. And I would recommend getting Resident Evil for the Sega Saturn, you know. Okay. Yeah, so I got a few Japanese games, but for the Sega Saturn. Now, this one is it's called Jaiswa. Okay, Japanese special weapons and tactics. And this is a full motion video force patient shooter where you're tapping the SWAT team. You go to warehouse passages and you have to kill all the bad guys. It runs in a small little window, as you can see. You're looking through the mask of the Japanese guy, and the cutscenes are fucking awesome. They're really funny, you know. The captain of the team is standing in front of his team. He looks like fucking R2-D2 because he's got a thing sticking out of his head like that, looking all badass and stuff. And they're all like 5 foot something. Sorry if I'm, but the dialogue is so fucking funny. They talk really fast in their own Japanese language. I just think it's funny. Sorry if I'm offending any Japanese people out there that might be watching this, but I just find it funny. You know, but it's a good game. All the characters are full motion video characters, and they don't they just do a series of pauses like that in 2 frames per second, like, you know, like if a hostage is like this putting trying to get away or something. It's really fucking weird, and the enemies, you know, just have like 2 frames of animation, you know. But it gets the job done. It's, I mean, they duck behind cover, they get up like that, you know what I mean, and then they shoot you. It's not like free flowing movement like Doom or something. So it's nothing special, but it's a fucking unique game, like. And you have a time limit in some of the levels to rescue the hostages or they all get killed. So, and it's like it's pretty good, but it's strange. I tell you that, it's strange. Yeah, so for JSWAT, it's I'll give it a 6 out of 10. It's unique, but it's pretty good. I mean, you know, but it's nothing special. So 6 out of 10, I wouldn't recommend it. The reason why I got this, because I was trying to get every force patient shooter available, and I'm sure there are other ones, but I can't, I mean, they all have Japanese text like that, so I had to fucking ask other people on YouTube, can you recommend any force patient shooters in the Sega Saturn? And they were saying, yeah, sure, what games do you have? And I told them what I have, and they told me about this one. And it says, well, it's okay. So it was €10, so it's worth €10 if you want something different and fucking unique to play. But I wouldn't recommend it. This is just for enthusiasts or collectors, I guess. You know, so JSWAT. Furious Mega Mix is an awesome beat 'em up game. It takes the combination. It takes Virtual 42, the Furious out of that, Fighting Vipers, which is an awesome beat 'em up as well. Fighting Vipers you should definitely get as well. But Furious Mega Mix smashes them all together in the big arena fight where they're all fighting each other. And the car from Daytona USA is in the game. It transforms into a fighter or something, which is strange. But Furious Mega Mix, definitely get it. You know, it's probably the best 3D fighting game on the Sega Saturn. You know, it has the best of Furious Mega Fighting Vipers, Virtua 42, and the car from Daytona USA. It's just an awesome beat 'em up, you know, in my opinion. But when it comes to 3D fighting games, Furious Mega Mix you should definitely get. You know, and Fighting Vipers again is an awesome beat 'em up game, you know, 3D beat 'em up game. Last Bronx, which was an arcade game, and this is a 3D beat 'em up, but you have weapons like bats and knives and swords and stuff like that, which is pretty good in my opinion. Last Bronx, you know, I'll definitely recommend it. And each of them games would give it 8 out of 10 for each. They're very good, I'd highly recommend them, you know. Brilliant games, you know. Panzer Dragoon 1 and 2 are awesome. It's like Afterburner, except you're on a dragon and you shoot everything on the screen. It's pretty cool, I find. Now, whenever I owned Panzer Dragoon Arte or Saga, I hear they're awesome, but they're more like RPG games. So like that's why I didn't rush to get them. I just preferred the Panzer Dragoon and Panzer Dragoon 2. But Panzer Dragoon 2 also goes with the name Panzer Dragoon Zwei, which is 2 in German, I think. You know what I mean? So, yeah. The whole series is awesome, you know? What else? Guardian Heroes is an awesome. It's sort of like Streets of Rage, but it's 2D. It's just a brilliant game, Guardian Heroes. 8 out of 10. Brilliant stuff. Yeah. So they're the games that I have, but they're not. I can't find them. But them games would give them all an 8 out of 10. I would recommend them all. House of the Dead, awesome. It's a light gun game. You're going shooting zombies. Awesome. It was an awesome arcade game, and it's awesome on the Sega Saturn. But like I said, if you're gonna get it and the light gun, you have to have an old school telly, because the light gun won't work on new modern televisions. That sucks, but that's just the way it is, Yeah, House of the Dead. I think there's a House of the Dead too. I think there is a sequel. I never owned that, so I don't know what it's like. But if there is, I say it's awesome. I think there is. I think there's a House of the Dead 3, 2 and 3. I'm not sure, but I have House of the Dead, and it's awesome. And back in the day, I had an old school telly, and I had the light gun and that, which was awesome. Now, Virtua Cop 1 and 2, I had them games, and I got the gun with Virtua Cop. Awesome game. You're shooting bank robbers and saving hostages. It was an awesome arcade game. It's awesome on the Sega Saturn. And them games would give a 9 out of 10 for each of them, Awesome stuff, in my opinion. So many great games on the Sega Saturn. It turned out to be a failure. Because the Sony PlayStation, for every great game that the Sega Saturn released, the Sony PlayStation had like something way better. That's just the way it was. Yeah, so onto the next one. Shell Shock, made by Carr, the same people that made Tomb Raider. This is a 3D tank game, and it's awesome in my opinion. I like this game a lot. You go around the city blowing up tanks. It's awesome. You can blow up buildings and other enemy vehicles. It's awesome in my opinion. It controls well. It has a good frame rate. It has good music, in my opinion. So, Shell Shock would definitely recommend it, and we'll give it an 8 out of 10. It's a deadly game. Next one, Wing Arms. Now, I like this game a lot. Now, when it comes to flying games and airplane games, it's not entirely accurate. For one thing, this is meant to be based on World War II aircraft. And I'm pretty sure that in World War II, there's no such thing as shields. Because in this game, you have shields. You can bounce off a mountain and nothing will happen. I'm pretty sure that's inaccurate. I'm pretty sure in World War II, there's no such thing like that. But it's still a fun game for what it is. It's a 3D airplane game. You're inside the cockpit. You're going on blowing up aircraft and ships and submarines and stuff. And it's like 4 or 5 different sort of aircraft to choose from. But they all act pretty much the same. They just look different, But we like the game, despite its inaccuracies. And sometimes a mountain or something just pop in out of nowhere. But it has good music, and I like the game. It's fun at the end of the day. And that's what matters. If a game is fun, that's all that matters, really. If a game entertains you, if you like it. So I like Wing Arms. Now, a lot of people don't really like it that much, but I like it. And Wing Arms, I would recommend it, And I'll give it an 8 out of 10. Now, I wouldn't be extremely generous there, but it's pretty good, That's what it looks like, So yeah, I there is a behind the view thing, which see we haven't played this game in years, so but it is a good game. It's just not entirely accurate, with the shields and stuff. See, I do a game that you actually like a lot, RoboPit. I can't even pronounce the name of these boys, but this is extremely basic. It's a polygonal first person beat 'em up game for robots, and you can build your robot from scratch with whatever you want. You can name it whatever you want, different sort of legs, arms. So it's highly customizable, and it's a very fun game to play. It has good frame rate and stuff. But it is babyish and it is made for kids, but we still have a lot of fun playing this game, because I can customize my robot any way I want. And it has good music. So RoboPit It's pretty good on the Sega Saturn. It's on the Sony PlayStation as well. You can give them badass arms like that if you want to, or whatever, you know. So RoboPit, it's very good. I would highly recommend it. I would give it an 8 out of 10. It's just a classic game, in my opinion. And that's a game I'd like to see in the Xbox One or something. The Ronto game is fucking terrible. Independence Day, the game. $14.99. Look, I fucking ripped off, I did. By Fox Interactive. Okay. Okay, the movie was good, you know, but the game was just fucking boring. You fly around in the F-14 there, blowing up all the little aircraft. Then 5 minutes later, the big ship opens up to destroy the world, you know, and you fire a missile into it, it blows up. So you're in Washington, then you're in New York, then you're in some fucking canyon, you know. 15 minutes and that's pretty much it, you know what I mean? You just do the same thing over and over again. But it has, it is two players and it has a split screen mode, which is okay. But it's just a boring game, you know. You destroy the loads of these and just blow up the main ship. It's just a boring game. It runs pretty well, but it's just nothing special, you know. They should have put more effort into it, you know. And fucking Electronic Arts, Centropolis Entertainment, fucking Radical Entertainment, a lot of companies were involved with this, but Fox Interactive is the main developer, I guess, you know. So Independence Day, it's just boring, in my opinion, you know. But we'll give it a 3 out of 10. I wouldn't recommend it. We got ripped off, $14.99. The guy was quite fucking laughing at me as I walked out of the shop. You know what I mean? But this is near the end of the Sega Saturn's life cycle, 1997. You know, the Sega Saturn was pretty much on its deathbed after what fucking Bernie Stoller said. But yeah, 3 out of 10 for Independence Day. It's on the PlayStation as well, so I'd give it a miss, you know, in my opinion, you know. We're on to the next game. Hang on, 96. Now, this is based on the old school Hang-On that was on the Mega Drive in the arcade. It's good, but it's not as good as Manx TT Superbike in the fact that the graphics look a bit fucking ropey, if that makes any sense. And if you hit off something, you just bounce all over the place. But it has a good frame rate and it has good music. It's just not a finished fucking game, I don't think, you know. But it's good. I mean, it has 6 circuits and 3 playable views. A series of 10 powerful GP machines, so it is a good game. It's not terrible. Manx TT was just so much better. It had a higher frame rate, better graphics, and just better everything when it comes to motorcycles. So Hang On GP 96, I'd give it a 7 out of 10. I'd still recommend it. It's still a very good game, and pretty good, you know, in my opinion. Now onto a game that was awesome, I think. Firestorm Thunderhawk 2. You know, locate, intercept, and destroy by car. Now, this is an awesome helicopter game, 3D perspective, first person view inside the cockpit. You can fire hell, fire missiles, blow up all the tanks, all the other helicopters. It's a great game. The first Thunderhawk came out on the MCD, which was good. So the sequel is even better, and rightfully so, you know. So, I would highly recommend this game. It's on the PlayStation as well. So we'll give it an 8 out of 10 Thunderhawk 2. That's great music as well. So yeah, great stuff. There's loads of great games in the Sega Saturn. The fucking classic Sega Ages Volume 1. After Burner 2, Space Area Outrun. 10 out of 10. You know, we played these games in the arcade all the time. And yeah, Sega Saturn versions are fucking brilliant. So I'd highly recommend this. And we'll give it a 10 out of 10. It's just as simple as that. Brilliant. Wait, I'm gonna do one more and then I'm gonna call an end to this because I wanna do some other stuff, but I'll continue on some other time. I'm gonna end this particular part with Quake. Brilliant. That's all I can say. Fucking Lobotomy Software once again proved to everyone that the Sega Saturn can do a 3D first person shooter. Now everyone was saying it's impossible, but Lobotomy Software prove everyone wrong. Now they had to change certain things to make a run on the Sega Saturn, and they had to reduce the size of the levels dramatically. And but the car concept of Quake is intact in the gameplay, and it has four exclusive Sega Saturn levels. It has great music by Nine Inch Nails, and it has great lighting effects. Awesome. And people are saying it's impossible, but brilliant. And this is just an amazing game, and I would highly recommend it if you're going to get a Sega Saturn. So this is a technical achievement for the Sega Saturn. You know, I didn't even think this would be possible, because this came out after Duke Nukem, and this is a highly intense 3D game. So it's fucking awesome, in my opinion. So we'll give it a 10 out of 10. It's a great game, and the Sega Saturn version holds its own, in my opinion. So I'm going to end this part, and we'll continue on some other time. So thanks very much for watching, if you are watching. If you want to leave any comments, if you want to hit the like button, go ahead and subscribe if you want to. So thanks very much, and we'll see you all later. Bye-bye.